Hey guys, what's up? It's 8-Bit Eric. Now, yesterday, Nintendo had its Nindy Summer Showcase. 22 different games are coming over to the Nintendo Switch from now until early next year. A lot of indie games have been coming out already. So many that it's just complete nuts. I didn't get my chance to talk about my impressions of the Direct since I missed out on it yesterday. But now, today's video, I'm going to talk, share, give my thoughts, go over each game very briefly. And yeah, so let's go ahead and begin. Now, the first game was Hyper Light Drifter. Some people would say this is a game that set a standard for a lot of indie titles that are already on the Nintendo Switch, such as Kamiko. And yeah, so I didn't get to play this game the first time around. I'm actually pretty excited that now that it's coming to the Switch, I get to sink my teeth into it. And actually, that's why I'm really glad about a lot of these games, because there's a lot of games that were announced that have already been out for quite some time, and now I get to experience them the first time. And this actually looks really cool. It looks like something that will keep me occupied. I played a lot of the other games, as I mentioned, that are on the Switch already that are similar to this, and I'm definitely looking forward to it. Now, the next game was Towerfall. This actually features some upgrades. I just missed out on Hyper Light Drifter. That has some Nintendo Switch exclusive content. So does Towerfall. There's going to be characters from Celeste featured in this game. It looks like a frantic co-op multiplayer type of game that looks perfect for parties, and I'm all about that. You know, anything that you can set up and pick up and play anywhere, which features with the Nintendo Switch, I'm all A-okay in that regard for it. Towerfall looks really, really neat and awesome. Next, we had Treasure Stack, which is a combination of a puzzle game with platforming, use grappling hooks. It looks really neat, but the main coup de grace for me in regards to this game is the fact that it's supporting cross-platforming with PC and Xbox One. I think that is fantastic that Nintendo is jumping aboard the cross-platform play train. That means it makes it more accessible for you to play with friends all over the world. And I'm all for that. I think that, in my opinion, is a good thing. This game looks like it's going to be a lot of fun. It's creative. It's not your basic puzzler. There's a lot of puzzle games on the eShop right now. This one looks like it's something that's doing a little bit different. And sure, you know, it's going to be a while for this one to come out. It's coming out in the winter. But it's something that I think is going to come out at a great time. A lot of people are going to be getting Nintendo Switches over the holidays. They're going to want games that they can play with their friends that might have other consoles besides the Switch, and you don't want to be left in the dust with that. So this looks like it's gonna be something that people are going to enjoy. Next up, we had a few other games that caught my attention. Zarvot, which looks like it's a neat little artsy type of game that's touchy. It's all about friendship and everything. Looks like it's going to be something that is enjoyable just for the story. We also had Minico's Night Market, and this one actually kind of touched my heart a little bit just by the fact that you're playing as a Japanese girl who operates a night market. You explore a village, you do challenges and stuff. I'm a sucker for cutesy, artsy little games like this. We also had Samurai Gun 2, which is a sequel to Samurai Gun, obviously. There's going to be a brand new adventure mode. This is a brawler type of game. It looks really, really neat. It includes a four-player versus mode. And yeah, again, another multiplayer type of game that I'm glad is going to be coming out. The more the merrier when it comes to my type of games. We also have Bullet Age, which is being launched as a console exclusive in November. It's a co-op game that features sword and gun gunplay. It looks like it has an extensive amount of features and stuff, something that people could get into this type of environment and stuff. Again, these are indie games that feature a lot of gameplay elements and stuff that take advantage of how the Switch operates, which is why I think they're going to be something to look for. The World Next Door was a game that I saw that actually looked pretty crazy looking. Like, I don't know, it looked totally outrageous. Characters look very anime-ish and stuff. This looks like a very story-driven game with puzzle elements. Thought that game seemed a little strange, but I like strange. And one good thing about this indies just being thrown out there is I'm going to get to play a lot of stuff that I normally wouldn't have played, just because I'm so fanatical about the Nintendo Switch. Now, Levelhead, I feel, gave off like a little bit of a Mario Maker vibe. You're able to create levels in this game, upload them, and play, and share them with your friends. Now, this is really neat. It encourages that, you know, interaction with other players and stuff. I really want Mario Maker to come over to the Nintendo Switch, but I guess Levelhead is going to have to be the substitute for now. It's going to support four-player co-op. Again, another multiplayer game that brings a lot of people close together, playing together. And I think that is ultimately the mission of the Switch. And if indies are getting it, then, you know, eventually first party games will also be following suit. I think a lot of what happens in the gaming industry evolves from indie games being creative. And Levelhead actually takes on the whole thing from Mario Maker and builds up upon it. Could you imagine if Mario Maker had four-player co-op? Now, Untitled Goose Game looked completely wacky. Any game that you can play as a goose and just cause havoc and ruin a human's daily life is already a Game of the Year candidate in my book. The graphics leave a little to be desired, but I can already tell you the gameplay and everything featured in this game looks amazing. I really cannot wait to try Untitled Goose Game. And in fact, I hope the title of the game stays Untitled Goose Game. I think that alone is enough price of admission for me to want to try and check it out. Now, Into the Breach is actually one that made a lot of waves. I saw a lot of people being excited about it. It came out on PC earlier this last year. It's a turn-based strategy game. You control a lot of like mechs. I think it looks pretty badass. It has alien invasion elements, things like that. I didn't get to experience it, so I'm probably totally way off the mark on what it looks like. But aside from what I just saw in the trailer, I'm definitely looking forward to this. A lot of people have hyped it up for me, and I heard that this one is a very huge dark horse candidate for indies on the Nintendo Switch. This one actually made some waves. So let's hope Into the Breach on the Switch is about as much fun as I think it is. If you've played it before, let me know. Comment down below. Now, releasing later this next week, The Messenger, basically an homage to Ninja Gaiden, which is one of the classic games of all time. It's a 2D platforming ninja game. What else do I have to talk about it? This one actually looks like it's going to be another heavy contender for the Nintendo Switch. I'm definitely going to be picking this one up. I saw a lot of my friends already have covered it on their Switch channels. I'm a little jealous, I'm not going to lie, but I absolutely cannot wait for The Messenger to be coming out this next week. This is going to be definitely a must-play and a must-buy. Another game that looked cool was Bastion. It's an action RPG game. You basically go on a journey and you play, you know, just overall it just looked really good. The trailer got me pretty hyped. I'm all about these type of action RPG type of games that give you a lot of an extensive gameplay. You know, Zelda is one of those types of games. This one looks like it's going to be a pretty fair indie title. I'm not sure if it's come out before, but this is also releasing in September, and it looks like it's going to be a load of fun. And there's other RPGs coming out also that were announced. For example, Wasteland, I believe it's called like Wasteland Director's Cut. That one actually looked pretty interesting, as well as Undertale. That's one of the greatest indie games of all time. It's finally coming out on the Nintendo Switch. Another example of a game that I never got to experience or play myself. So that is definitely one that I'm also going to be getting. Desert Child looked like a pretty neat little game that has you trying to accomplish certain tasks and everything in order to, I guess, race. That one looked really pretty cool and all. Other games that were showcased and shown on this Nintendo Nindie Summer Showcase. You know, there was a few other. I can't think of them off the top of my head. But just to name a good amount, this was pretty good. I think it was a pretty good showcase. Lots of really high quality indies are coming out. I could never be more excited. Just to give a little heads up on what I'm saying in regards to the Indies Direct, I know a lot of people had concerns that there's just way too many indies coming out and they felt underwhelmed about this. I mean, it was being advertised as a Nindies showcase. These are pretty good indie games. Even if some of them are old and years old, not everybody has played them, like myself. There's a lot of these that I have not even played once. And for the fact that I'm going to be able to play them, not only on my TV, but on the go, I'm definitely excited. I think the fact that Nintendo is drip feeding a lot of these indie games over time in between big releases shows that they have a lot of faith in the console. So for me, I'm looking at the silver lining of it. The Nindie Showcase actually brought a lot of excitement to me that I'm getting forward to checking out. So there's a lot of games for me to look at. I mean, already I've over have like over 100 games just alone on my Switch that I still have to complete and play through because there's just so many coming out. And this Nindie Summer Showcase, in my opinion, was fantastic. So what did you guys think about it? I know a lot of you are just so upset that these big titles are being held off. It takes time. But I'm also really excited about how many indie games I'm going to experience for the first time. So comment down below. If you're new, throw that subscription, hit that like button, subscribe if you can. Check out some more videos right here. And if you want to get an 8-Bit Eric Club t-shirt, merch link right here, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. Appreciate every single one of you. Peace out.